Within the hour, the Sheriff's Department releasing the name and picture of the deputy who was killed. This is Sergeant Bobby Swartz. The sheriff saying at a news conference earlier today that he was a veteran member of the force.
About 45 minutes ago, law enforcement, as you see from across the state, saluted Sergeant Swartz as his flag-draped casket was loaded into a hearse, going to the medical examiner's office before being taken to a funeral home. Former Oklahoma County Sheriff John Wetzel saying on social media tonight, Sergeant Swartz was a good man, a superb and dedicated deputy who served with pride and professionalism. Going on to say, he sacrificed his life for the citizens of Oklahoma County. News 4's Kaylee Olivas is live at OU Medical Center.
And Kaylee, we heard from several members of the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office earlier today.
Yeah, Jolene, Kevin, each one of those officers and deputies that you've heard from today say it has been a tragic and crazy day, to say the least. And like you all mentioned before, this all started around 1:30 early this afternoon, where deputies were called to serve an eviction notice to a home in Oklahoma City near Southwest 78th and Young's Street in that area. And this is what they say is a routine service that they provide, and it ended very tragically today as they were supposed to stick it on one man's door, and instead it turned into what you all have seen today on our newscast. Now, deputies did say they spoke with someone, and that person then opened fire as deputies went to the back of the home. Those two deputies were shot, one of which tried to pull the other to safety. They were brought here to OU Medical in Oklahoma City, where they were being treated. And unfortunately, Sergeant Bobby Swartz has unfortunately passed away. And as you can see on your screen, officers from all over the state of Oklahoma led a procession about a mile north of here to the medical examiner's office. And we were right here standing as all of that unfolded. And it was a very sad thing to watch. I was nearly in tears watching them go down the street and all of these officers comforting one another, hugging one another, saying that it's going to be okay. But everyone was in tears. Now, as deputies came out, you could see tears on everyone's face, as I was saying, and Sheriff Tommy Johnson held a press conference here earlier, but he couldn't make it through as he was visibly upset over today.
Law enforcement is a tight community, and man, I'm so thankful. They were screaming across the state for my guys.
This was about as routine as it gets. These guys, what they do is they do lockouts and serve papers, and that's pretty much all they do, and they do it extraordinarily well.
Now, we have confirmed through the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office the other deputy is in stable condition, but we are not aware of who he is yet, as that information will be released tomorrow morning. Like I was saying, I mean, it is a very somber mood out here. As you can see, there were officers earlier, but now they've all gone out in that procession. We will continue to be right here at OU Medical to continue giving updates, and we'll let you know if we find out who that other deputy was who was involved in this shooting. In Oklahoma City, I'm Kaylee Olivas.
All right, Kaylee, thank you. Very emotional day there. This is a Facebook post from the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office. It reads in part, "Today, the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office mourns the loss of a good man."
And a lot of reaction coming in from local officials. Oklahoma County Commissioner Carrie Blumert saying in a statement, quote, "I am sad and angry to learn that two of our deputies have been shot today in the line of duty. Tragically, one of those deputies succumbed to his injuries. It's a sad day in Oklahoma County." Our deputies, as well as all law enforcement officers across Oklahoma County, work daily to keep the citizens of Oklahoma County safe. My thoughts and prayers are with our two deputies, their families, and all the members of the Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office.
Right now, News 4's Natalie Clydesdale continues our team coverage.
And Natalie, tonight we're also hearing from witnesses about this shooting, how it started earlier today.
Right, it's been a very emotional afternoon here on Southwest 78th Street, and like you both said, this is where it all started, and it is still a very active scene. Nearly 6 hours later, police cars are still lining the street, and two new crime scene unit investigators just got here within the last half hour or so, and they've begun their process of investigating the scene. Now, I talked with neighbors earlier who say this incident has left them on edge, and they are very shaken up. They say this is typically a very quiet, peaceful neighborhood, and they don't think twice about letting their children outside to play, and they are very, very upset about this. Now, I'll give you a look over at the scene here. We had the camera facing this way to avoid a little bit of a glare, so it might be tough to see the house where this incident happened, but it is where that silver car is. According to a witness, the suspect was in the garage when deputies arrived and started shooting at them from inside. And another neighbor told me he was outside working on his vehicle when he heard the gunshots. And like I said, this has shaken up the entire neighborhood.
It is scary. You're just like, why would you do that? You know, like, there's kids around, you know, families around. Like, you never know. Like, he could have missed and shot a baby or something.
There's a lot of kids that play outside, so it makes me feel worried about the little kids also. It makes me feel angry, very angry.
Now, we are waiting to release the suspect's name until we get the word from officials that it is okay to do so. But neighbors tell us they believe it is someone, a man, who was in his mid-30s. And they say he typically keeps to himself, and they've never had any problems, especially none as severe as this, ever before with him. Reporting live, Natalie Clydesdale, Oklahoma's News 4.
Natalie, thank you. Let me show you what it looked like from Chopper 4 as it followed the shooting suspect in his gray Dodge truck along I-35 and onto I-40. And you see, he was pulling a boat the entire time. Along the way, he hit construction barrels along I-40 and fired shots at officers. His run from the law eventually ending here at the main gate at Tinker Air Force Base.
The suspect left in a vehicle. A description was given out. Oklahoma City police officers located that suspect vehicle a short distance away shortly after the shooting occurred. Tried to stop the vehicle, and they were involved in a pursuit with the suspect, which led through the city and eventually ended here at Tinker Air Force Base. During that pursuit, the suspect was firing rounds at officers, and we had officers as well returning fire at the suspect. Once the suspect got here at Tinker Air Force Base, he ended up surrendering and was taken into custody.
That suspect dropping an AR-15 when he surrendered. The main gate at Tinker, which had been closed after all this happened, is now back open this evening.
Mason Dunn is back above the scene in McIntyre Law Chopper 4 tonight. And Mason, something pretty rare today. The police helicopter landing in the middle of a neighborhood street to help. And we're looking now at the backyard where this took place.
Yeah, right now you're looking live from McIntyre Law Chopper 4. This is the backyard of the residence where the shooting happened. You can see investigators are back there. They have crime scene tape up. We've seen the bulletproof vest laying on the ground here behind the house where medical personnel were working on the two officers. We'll come back around. We're looking at the street here. This is where Air One did land in front of this house. They eventually landed here to pick up one of the officers who was shot to take them to the hospital. They didn't end up doing that. They ended up running them down the street to the ambulance. So right now you're looking in front of the house. You see the crime scene vehicles. A lot of vehicles are still like time.
Okay, Mason, have a little trouble with his signal right now, but we also want to tell you this evening we are learning more about the home where the shooting happened. Court documents showing a victim's protection order, commonly known as a VPO, filed against a family member by someone living in the home within the past month. We also know an eviction notice was filed by a family member to evict another family member. That family member reportedly owed $1,500 in back rent. That's why deputies were at the home today. They were serving the eviction notice when the shooting happened. We'll likely learn much more in the coming days.
Also tonight, the investigation ongoing. The Oklahoma County Sheriff's Office mourning the loss of one of their own.
Sergeant Bobby Swartz being remembered tonight by his friends and colleagues from around the state, but more importantly, his family. We'll be right back.